A war between the White House and America's top court is escalating, with the Supreme Court striking down a key proposal by Joe Biden to forgive billions in student loans. As US correspondent Catherine Firkin reports, the move is just the latest in a string of controversial decisions by the court, which is dominated by conservatives.
Outside the Supreme Court, anger is building. Millions of students now forced to pay back loans they'd been promised were wiped.
We're here for justice. We are here for dignity. And we are here for President Biden to keep his promise. We need a plan B. We need it now.
President Joe Biden's plan to cancel student debt crushed after the Supreme Court ruled his administration doesn't have the authority to do so.
You know, these Republican officials just couldn't bear the thought of providing relief for working class, middle class Americans.
In an angry tirade, Biden lashed the conservative justices and questioned how Republicans could have supported the Paycheck Protection Program during the pandemic, but not this program, which costs almost 50% less and helps lower earners.
Come on, the hypocrisy is stunning. You can't help a family making 75 grand a year, but you can help a millionaire and you have your debt forgiven?
The ruling is just one in a string of controversial decisions. Today, the nation's highest court also ruled in favour of a Christian graphic artist who refused to design a website for a gay couple.
I'm a Christian. I believe that marriage is between a man and a woman, and I want to create messages that are consistent with that faith.
But it sets precedent moving forward that it is okay to discriminate against LGBTQ people in America.
And just 24 hours after affirmative action in universities was struck down, another contentious decision regarding race. The court turned away a case that challenges Mississippi's rules around voting rights for those with felony convictions. The policy was implemented more than a century ago with the explicit goal of preventing black people from voting. Catherine Firkin for 10 News First, New York.
France's interior minister claims the violence sparked by teenagers shooting is easing despite another night of turmoil across the country. The worst appears to have broken out in Marseille, where dozens were arrested. A library was set on fire and thousands of security forces were deployed to try and calm the anger. Crowds attacked officers, shooting fireworks, throwing rocks and looting and vandalising shops. In an attempt to quell the violence, several French celebrities have appealed to the rioters to stop, including footballer Kylian Mbappe, who called for the violence to be replaced with mourning, dialogue and reconstruction. At least 48 people have been killed when a truck apparently lost control and rammed into other vehicles and pedestrians at a busy junction in western Kenya. 30 others were seriously injured by the runaway truck, which also slammed into several crowded bus stops. Witnesses say the truck had been trying to avoid a bus that had broken down on the road when the driver lost control. Brazil's former President Jair Bolsonaro has been handed a hammer blow to his political aspirations, banned from running for office for almost a decade. Bolsonaro was found guilty of abusing his power ahead of last year's presidential poll and will not be allowed to run for 8 years. He had been accused of undermining Brazilian democracy by falsely claiming that the electronic ballots used were vulnerable to hacking and fraud. Bolsonaro has reacted angrily, vowing to appeal. Residents living around the Warner Brothers studio in LA have reported hearing a big bang before smoke began billowing from a fire on the Burbank property. The studio's famous water tower was shrouded in smoke, igniting fears that some of the lot's sound stages and props might have been burning. But local firefighters confirmed the blaze was isolated to a power transformer and was quickly put out. Warner Brothers and other Hollywood studios might soon have a much larger fire to put out, with hundreds of actors indicating they are prepared to strike for better conditions. They would join thousands of already striking screenwriters demanding better pay, streaming royalties and clarification around the role of artificial intelligence. If the actors join the writers, it will be the first time two unions have gone on strike in more than 60 years, paralysing the industry. Alan Arkin, the American actor who won an Oscar for Little Miss Sunshine, has died. His sons confirmed his death in an online statement paying tribute to his long and varied career. The New York-born and Los Angeles-raised actor, director and screenwriter actually started out in music, playing in a band called The Tarriers, which released its own version of the Banana Boat song, made famous by Harry Belafonte. But acting is what brought Arkin fame, winning a Best Actor Tony for his first Broadway play. He later appeared in dozens of films, series and plays, finally winning an Oscar and BAFTA for playing the foul-mouthed grandfather in Little Miss Sunshine alongside Toni Collette.
Can I give you some advice? Well, I'm going to give it to you anyway. I don't want you making the same mistakes I made when I was young.
Can we hear this?
Dwayne, that's your name, right? Dwayne? This is the voice of experience talking. Are you listening?
Acting was more than just a job for Arkin. In his 2018 memoir, he revealed he felt ignored as a child and acting allowed him to feel as if he was alive. Alan Arkin was 89.